Hey guys, I'm back, and basically what I'm gonna be telling you about today is learning disabilities. So like, subscribe, and comment if you have a learning disability, and if you have a learning disability, it's okay, I have one too, so don't be shy. And also comment what you think that our channel fans or subscribers, like my channel fan or subscribers, should be called. Because I've been on YouTube for at least a year, I think, and I only have 5 subscribers. So, you 5 subscribers that I have, I am greatly appreciative of you guys. Shout out to Mo, my best friend. What's up? But anyway, let's get on with the video. So how it's diagnosed is It's really confusing, but how learning disabilities are diagnosed is by getting an RTI, which means response to intervention, or going to a psychologist and getting diagnosed that way. Basically, what an RTI is you have like a teacher or a psychologist or something monitor your progress closely to identify possible learning problems that you have, and if you have a learning problem or a learning disability, then you will be identified as having problems with help or with help on different levels or tiers. And I have no idea what tiers mean, but like it's spelled T-I-E-R-S. I'm like, I don't know what that means, but I'm just gonna go with levels. Let's go with levels. But anyway, a learning disability is basically like I'm gonna tell you what a learning disability is. So basically, a learning disability is simply a condition giving the difficulties to learn and have that expectation that like your teacher or anybody wants you to have, and like you can't meet that expectation because you can't focus, or you're a little bit slow and you don't understand as well as other people do. So you have to just space out. That's how you focus. That's basically, you know, that at least that is for me. If you have a learning disability, everybody has it different. Everybody reacts to learning disabilities in a different way. There's so many different ones. And, for example, there's dyscalculia, which is a math, learning disability. There's dyslexia, which is a, word and speech one, I think. Well, you get your letters mixed up, that's all I know. But, so, that's basically what, a learning disability is. But it's not associated with physical handicap. When some people think disability, they think, oh, they're handicapped, or they can't, like, they're disabled and they can't do, they can't walk, or they can't move their arms, or they're just, like, paralyzed. That's not what a learning disability is. That's what a learning disability is. Is basically what I just said. Like, what I just said was, you know, it's with your mind, and you're mentally handicapped. If that made any sense to you, comment down below and say yes, it made sense. So the facts, between 5% and 8% of school-aged children have some type of memory or subjective defect in their brain that interferes with their ability to learn concepts or procedures in one or more mathematical or other subjects. It's not just math. I know I have trouble in math, but it's not like normal people that have trouble. Like, I'm not a normal person. I'm socially awkward. I think anybody who goes on YouTube is socially awkward. Probably anybody that I watch is socially awkward. But I'm more shy than my friends are. And, like, I have major anxiety. And that's another thing I'm going to be talking to you about. Anxiety is a major, major thing. And you can have it with a learning disability. And there's also, you can, if I think it makes it worse if you have ADHD or ADD. It makes it worse with anxiety. Anxiety is basically when you have trouble and you have like a bunch of stuff you need to do and you just like start to feel like you're closed in and you're just like really stressed all the time and like you worry about stuff and you worry all the time and you're so stressed. So basically what anxiety does to your body is like not okay. So I have it pulled up and I'm gonna look what, okay, I don't think, okay, I got it, I got the definition right here, guys. I was wrong. Yes, so anxiety is a disorder, not a disability. There are two different words. So anxiety disorder, I don't know why I'm fist, but anxiety disorder is a mental health disorder characterized by feelings of worry, anxiety, or fear that are strong enough to interfere with one's daily activities. So basically the symptoms that you would have to have anxiety would be fatigue, restlessness, or sweating, which I think everyone has, but your whole body may experience that. Your behavior may be hypervigilance or irritability. I don't know what those words mean, but you know. Your conjunctive may be racing thoughts or unwanted thoughts. I have racing thoughts all the time. There'd be like, for me, I don't know about you, but like, anxiety is different for everybody. But like, if you're watching this and you have anxiety and you don't want to hear about it, bear with me. This will only take about a few more minutes. But anxiety with a learning disability is not a good thing, because you would just be so stressed out and you would just be so confused at the same time that you can't take it anymore. You just like want to like break down and cry. And I have done that before. That'll be in a story time, so check that out after I make that video. But basically, anxiety mixed with a learning disability and ADD or ADHD is not a good thing. You do not have to, you don't need to have three things mixed up at a time. Like, if you have dyscalculia with ADD or ADHD and you have anxiety, you're going to have a life full of horrible confusion and stress, and you're gonna need to live with a person that you can stand, because you won't be able to take care of yourself. I know that's gonna happen to me, because I'm gonna have to live with my friend Morgan, and I'm gonna be so confused and I'm not gonna like it. But also, what's also common in anxiety is anxiety, excessive worry, fear, feeling of impending doom. Don't know if that's suicide or just death in general. Insomnia, nausea, poor concentration, sense of abnormal heartbeat or trembling, I have about 95% of that. So, it's not good to self-diagnose yourself, I know, but I did anyway. And the treatments for anxiety are you could go to therapy, you can go to self-care, which is stress management, avoid alcohol, reduce your caffeine intake. Definitely want to do that. You can also, with your learning disabilities, you need some stuff to like stimulate your mind. So like take a break with your, if you have a learning disability, take a break. If you're doing like homework and stuff, take a break. Definitely take a break. If you're, doing something that involves thinking, take a break after like 20, 25 minutes. Just take a break. You need that break for yourself. But the other treatments for anxiety are stress management, avoid alcohol, reduce your caffeine intake, physical exercise, smoking. Don't do drugs, kids. I'm not saying do drugs. I'm saying don't do drugs. So don't smoke. Don't do the what this is, and don't smoke for your anxiety. I don't care what your doctor says. Don't smoke. Do not smoke, kids. Smoking is bad for you. Even though how much they say it's good for you, it's bad for you. Really bad. Anyway, relaxation techniques, and you want to have a healthy diet. I mean, you should have a healthy diet already, but diets don't ever work, so just try it. Try it for once. You could also take medications that are subscribed to you. Subscribe, prescribe, whatever. You could also see a specialist. There's so many different treatments that you could do. Just ask somebody that you know and do a treatment there. If you have really bad anxiety, you should go to there's a therapy called psychotherapy. Okay. You could also do meditation. It calms your nerves, you know. You could do that. For the medications, I would definitely not recommend to do. Don't take your medication. Don't take anxiety medications because it'll just make you even more stressed and stuff because, yeah. And this says antidepressants. You want to take the medications on here. You don't want to take a sedative because that just paralyzes you temporarily. An antioxalic. Don't know what that is. And nerve pain medication. I don't know what that is either, but it sounds very painful. So don't do that. I just wanted to tell you guys about learning disabilities and anxiety with that. And if you like this video, I will tell you about my anxiety breakdown. Well, I think it was a panic attack, but I'm not sure. So, either way, I will tell you about it if you want me to. And just subscribe, like, and comment down below. If you have a learning disability and what my subscribers should be called. Love you. Have a great day and love Supernatural. Bye.